हरे कृष्णा। डोंट लेट अ प्रोपेंसिटी फॉर इमेंसिटी ऑब्स्क्योर द सुप्रीमेसी ऑफ इंटीमेसी। प्रोपेंसिटी फॉर इमेंसिटी रेफर्स टू द propensity's inclination, attraction towards immensity, towards thinking, looking at big things. So propensity for immensity in the spiritual realm refers to the conception that God, if he is big, he must be big in terms of size. He must be a giant who pervades all of existence. So such people conceive of God's greatness in terms of size. Now the Bhagavad Gita is a spiritually accommodating and inclusive book that provides pathways and provision and arrangements for people from all various different mindsets and backgrounds to progress on the spiritual expressway. So it also accommodates those who have this propensity for immensity by its revelation of the awe-inspiring Vishwarupa, Virata Rupa, in its 11th chapter. This theophany, the word theophany refers to a visible manifestation of God. The manifestation is visible, but it's not all necessarily material, but basically it's perceivable to the senses. So theophany. This theophany, which is revealed in the 11th chapter, it is so huge that it spans the entire visual range of Arjuna. He looks up, looks down, looks left, looks right, and nowhere does he find the end of anything. And he says in 11.16, Anek Bahu Daravatra Netram. So he, what is he saying? Anek Bahu. He's saying many arms, Udara bellies, Vaktra faces, Netram eyes. So then he, as he goes on describing the universal form, he says, Nantam na madhyam na punastavadim. I can't see your beginning, your middle, your end. Pashyami tvam Vishveshwara Vishwarupa. Pashyami, I see what? Oh, you are the Vishveshwara and you are the Lord of the universe, and I see your Vishwarupa. I see your universal form. And when I see this universal form, what happens by seeing the form? Arjuna becomes overwhelmed. So in that, this is a panoply of arms and legs and ornaments and garments and bellies and faces and teeth and eyes, and it's overwhelming. So now the Bhagavad Gita reveals this, but the Bhagavad Gita does not endorse it as the highest manifestation of divinity. In fact, it expresses its disapproval of obsession with immensity through the reaction of Arjuna. Arjuna's initial request to see this form, and the acharyas explain that Arjuna's request is not because of his own desire, but because of his desire to vindicate Krishna's supremacy, which he has mentioned through words, later through actions. So through Krishna not only said that everything is contained within me, that's he said in the 10th chapter, I sustain everything. But in 11th chapter, he demonstrates that. So now, Arjuna, after he sees this, what happens? He doesn't fall in love with the Vishwarupa. He actually desires, I don't want to see it anymore. I want to see your two-handed form, which I can adore and love. Now, Krishna repeats, or the Vishwarupa, Krishna is manifesting there as the Vishwarupa. Krishna repeatedly reminds him, this Vishwarupa is very, very rare. Adrishta Purvam Rishitosmi. Adrishta Purvam, that this has never been seen before. Arjuna, this is a very rare vision. Why don't you want to see it? And he says, that you cannot see this by any ordinary means. Even by extraordinary means, it's difficult to see. But still Arjuna says, no, I don't want to see this form. I want to see a two-handed form. And then Krishna describes, after revealing the two-handed form, that actually, Sudurdarsham idam rupam. It says, Sudurdarsham idam rupam. It's extremely rare. What is extremely rare? Trishtavan asiyan mama. Yan asiyan. As I am right now, this form is very, very difficult to see. Devapyasya rupasya, deva apyasya rupasya. That this form which the gods have shown, or which I have seen, that even the devatas, नित्यं दर्शन कांक्षिणः, मतलब देवताज आर कॉन्स्टेंटली लॉन्गिंग टू सी दिस फॉर्म नित्यं दर्शन. सो इन दिस वे व्हाट हैपेंस इज दैट this form is so rare. So Bhagavata also demonstrates this. The Vishwarupa is rare, but the Rupa, the two-handed form of Krishna is even rarer. So now then, if that is not the highest, the Virat Rupa is not the highest, then why does the Bhagavata talk about this form? It is intermediate in the spiritual path. Now, the Bhagavata describes the various attitudes towards God in the verses from 9.11 to 9.15. And so 9.11-12 talks about those who deride God's personal form. Avajanantima mudha manushim tanumashritam. They consider Krishna's form to be temporary and illusory. Now that is one extreme, that is the lower end of the spectrum. Then Krishna talks about the top end of the spectrum, the pure devotees who devote themselves to Krishna in his personal manifestation as the supremely loving and supremely lovable person. That is 9.13 and 14. Here he describes that jnana yagena, by knowledge, by sacrifice of knowledge, they try to worship him only, Krishna only. Yajanto mam upasate. So they have three ways: ekatvena, those who consider themselves to be one of the absolute truth; pruthatvena, bahudha, those who consider that the one absolute truth is manifestation as the various gods; vishvatomukham, and one who has manifested as the Vishwarupa. So now when Krishna talks about this form as the Vishwarupa, so this is especially meant for those who have the propensity for immensity. So instead of they being attracted to big structures like the say the Eiffel Towers or the Himalayan mountains or the vast oceans or giant animals, whatever, you can become attracted to a giant manifestation of God. And if that raises them from gross material consciousness where they seek sensual pleasures to contemplation of God, then that is a stepping stone on their spiritual journey. But if that same propensity for immensity makes them think that, oh, God has to be very big, and when they come across Krishna, Krishna is just a small person like me only, because of the physical, because of the unimpressive seeming dimensions of Krishna, if they minimize Krishna's form, then that same propensity for immensity can become a stumbling block on their spiritual journey. And by Arjuna's preference, not for the Vishwarupa, but for the not for the Sahasrabaho Rupa, but for the Dvibaho Rupa, not for the form with thousands of arms, but the form for the form with two arms, what does the Gita demonstrate? That actually God and his intimate devotee, God and his highest devotees are interested not in displays of majesty, but in the place of intimacy. Yes, devotee is, oh Krishna, you are so great. No, Krishna wants to reciprocate love, perform leela, place of intimacy. And one such play of intimacy is manifest on the battlefield of Kurukshetra itself. Actually, in the setting of the Bhagavad Gita, that the original creator has become the personal charioteer of his dear warrior. So the dear warrior Arjuna, Krishna is Adikartre, he is the creator of Brahmaji also, but he has become the Parthasarathi. This is a play. So the supremacy of intimacy means that in the transcendental arena, what is most cherished is not just beholding the bigness of God, but it is relishing the sweetness of God. And that relishing of the sweetness of God is what Arjuna does by in his persona, in the with God in the personable manifestation. Personable means one who is a person who is lovable. So by becoming attracted to, by understanding that the Virat Rupa is a manifestation of Krishna, and so thinking that, oh, Krishna is so small and the Virat Rupa is so big, that actually this Krishna who seems to be so small is actually a source of that Virat Rupa. So that means that Virat Rupa I think have to be as great. And the source of that Virat Rupa is Krishna. How great he must be. And yet he looks so sweet also. So how wonderful it will be to love him. So let me offer my heart to him. And let me devote myself to him. Love for the Supreme Lord, it alone in his personal manifestation, that alone can fulfill our heart's longing for love. And it is this longing intimacy of love, the supremacy of the intimacy between God and the soul, this is the Gita's most confidential secret, and it is our life's highest achievement. Thank you. Hare Krishna.